Hello friends, welcome to our course Mechanics of Solid. These are our topics which we are going to discuss in this class. First mechanics, then pressure and stress, then stress and type of stresses, Shen-Wynn principle, strain and type of strains, Poisson's ratio. Okay, so let's come to the mechanics. Here we are studying mechanics of solid, so we should know the what is mechanics. Mechanics can be defined as that science which describe and predict the condition of rest or motion of body. Rest or motion of body under the action of force. Okay, this is important. So mechanics can be classified in three types. One is mechanics of rigid body. Second, mechanics of deformable body. Third, fluid mechanics. Mechanics of rigid body can be, here we study about the a part or body material. If you apply any external load, okay, if you apply any external load, body will not deform and it will be direct fracture without any deformation. Okay. Here we can classify rigid body mechanics in two types. One is static, second one dynamic. In static, whatever force we study on the body or part, there will be time independent. Means load will be constant, that will be not a function of time. Second one is dynamic. In case of dynamic, if you are study about the velocity or force, that will be function of the time. With respect to time, value will be changed. Dynamic can be again classified in two types. First one is kinematics, second one kinematic. Kinematics means we will study the velocity of any part, velocity, acceleration or displacement of any part without consider the force. In kinematics, we study the velocity, acceleration, displacement, everything with considering the forces. Mechanics of deformable body. This is also known as strength of material or mechanics of solid. This is our main subject. So it can be classified in two type, two group. One is theory of elasticity and second one theory of plasticity. In theory of elasticity, if you apply the force, body will deform. Okay, let's suppose this is deformed body. If you remove the force, body will regain its original shape in elasticity. But in plasticity, if you apply, body got deformed, that time it cannot be regain its original shape. Permanent change in shape. In mechanics of rigid body, body cannot be deformed, direct fracture. In mechanics of deformable body, initially body will be deformed up to some limit, then only it will be failure. Before failure or fracture, some deformation will be there. Fluid mechanics, compressible fluid, incompressible fluid. Here in this course, we will mainly consider about the theory of elasticity. Here you can see the in flowchart how we can classify, how we can make the groups, first, second, third. So in mechanics of solid, first word we generally read that one is stress and strain. In this lecture, we will study only simple stress and strain. So what is stress? The force of resistance per unit area offered by a body against deformation due to external force is known as intensity of stress or simply stress, and it is denoted by sigma. A unit of this one is here, unit of stress will be Newton per meter square. How? Because this is force per unit area. Here, if the load P is assumed to be uniformly distributed over the cross section, if we assume that force is uniformly distributed over the section or area, दैट टाइम स्ट्रेस इक्वल टू टोटल लोड डिवाइड बाई एरिया. ओके एंड यूनिट विल बी दिस वन. सेकेंड कंडीशन आई कैन से हियर कंडीशन वन. ओके सेकेंड कंडीशन इफ इंटेंसिटी ऑफ स्ट्रेस इज नॉट यूनिफॉर्म थ्रू आउट द बॉडी. लेट सपोज दिस इज ए पार्ट. ओके एंड इफ यू अप्लाई सम लोड, लोड इज नॉट यूनिफॉर्म. लेट सपोज वी आर अप्लाइंग दिस टाइप लोड सम वे, सो दैट टाइम स्ट्रेस एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट विल बी डिफरेंट. Different different point stress value will be different. And how we can find out that one? For a small area, this small area, we can find out the stress equal to load on this particular small area divided by that small area, infinitesimal area, very small area. Okay. So for a particular a small portion, we can find out using this one. If force and stress is same. You can find out using this formula. But one more thing, stress we said that force per unit area, we said like that, but pressure is also force per unit area. A unit of this one is Newton per meter square, here also Newton per meter square. Then how both are different? Yes, both are different. One is internal phenomena and one is external. If I say pressure, pressure can be defined as the amount of force applied per unit area. Okay, force applied per unit area, that is pressure here. But stress can be defined as the internal resistive force to the deformation per unit area. Due to pressure, stress will be developed. Due to stress, pressure will not be developed. When we apply some force on a body, that due to that stress will be generated on the body. But if there is some stress, pressure cannot be generated. The pressure is always positive force. It may be positive or negative stress. Okay. Pressure is exerted externally. Externally we apply the force. This develop internally. Pressure is always compressive. It may be tensile, compressive, or shear, something like that. Okay. Next one is stress and type of stress. Stress we already discussed. Then we will discuss type of stress. Stress may be direct stress or indirect stress. Initially, we will discuss about the direct stress. Direct stress means when we are applying some force on a body, we will see the direct stress directly to the force. Direct effect of the force we can see in form of stress. In indirect, we will apply some different kind of force, stress will be some different type. Okay, we'll discuss that one. In direct stress, we can again classify in normal stress, shear stress. Normal stress is the stress which act in direction perpendicular to the area. If there is one body, let's suppose this like this, stress will be perpendicular to the area. As this side, any side, but that will be always perpendicular. That will be normal stress. Okay. And normal stress can be classified in three types: tensile stress, compressive stress, bulk stress. Tensile stress means if the deformation of force on applied forces result in the increase in the object length. If due to applied force, if due to stress, if length is increasing, that time stress will be tensile stress. Here, increase in the object length, then the resulting stress is termed as tensile stress. Okay. For example, when a rod or wire is stretched by pulling, it will be equal and opposite force outward at both end. Okay, here you can see figure. Second one, compressive stress. Compressive stress decrease in the length. Due to external force, length is decreasing, that time stress will be generated is known as compressive stress. And in this condition you can see the example, load is acting inside compressive force, due to that here this second one dotted is new shape. Third one, bulk stress or volume stress. When the deforming force or applied force act from all direction, resulting in the change of volume of the object, then such stress is called as volumetric stress or bulk stress. In initially two cases, if you apply tensile force, length will be increased but volume will be same. Length increase, cross section will decrease. In case of compressive, length will be decreased, cross section area will be increased, but volume will be fixed. But in third case, bulk stress or volume stress, here volume will be changed. Final volume will be changed. Okay. Then shear stress. When the direction of deformation force on external force is parallel to the cross section area. Here you can see the example figure. This force acting in this side. Okay. This force is parallel to each other and also parallel to the this area. If I consider shear stress in this area, force is parallel to the this. Okay. Not the normal to this. If this force will be normal to this, then stress will be normal stress. But here parallel to the surface, and stress will be generally known as shear stress. Okay. Shearing stress or tangential stress. This result in the change in the shape of the body. In tensile, shape will be similar, but only length increase, decrease something. In compressive also, length will be increase or decrease, but similar kind of shape. In bulk stress, shape will be same, volume will be changed. In shear stress, volume will be same, but shape will be changed. Okay. Next, indirect stress. First one is bending. When we apply the, here you see this one, let's suppose initially it is like this. If you apply some force, it will be bent. Due to bending force, bending is moment, upper side of this beam will be under compressive and lower side will be under tension. Here compressive and tensile stress is generating, but we are applying bending. So whatever stress generating here, that is indirect stress. Okay. Second case, torsion. In case of torsion, if you apply twisting moment, here you can see we are applying twisting moment. Due to that, when we apply twisting moment, due to that shear stress will be generated in the body. We are applying twisting moment, but shear stress is generating. Therefore, that is indirect stress. Okay. When we are talking about the stress, one more important thing is Sen-Menon principle. What is that? According to Sen-Menon principle, the stress is uniform at the section away from the applied load, but there is variation of stress at the section near to the applied load. What is the meaning of that? Look in this figure A. When we apply the force, okay, initially we are using same amount of load throughout the section. Here we are applying one point load without any fixture. So when we apply point load away from the applied load, here let's suppose here stress will be uniform, you can see in shape also, but near to the applied force point load, stress variation will be there. Here stress is high, here less, and that you can see in this big figure. Okay. If I say called near to the applied load P, stress variation is like this bell shape. Okay. But if you go some distance from the applied load, variation is less. If you go long distance, at very high distance, stress will be uniformly throughout the area. that is saying by Sen-Whinam principle. Okay, so next type of strain. Strain means change in dimension per unit dimension is known as strain. If you apply the stress force, due to that body will deform, and due to deformation change dimension per unit dimension is known as strain. And it can be again classified in several, in various type. First one you can say tensile strain. Strain generated due to tensile stress will be known as tensile strain. Due to tensile strain generating means we are applying tensile force, due to that length will be increased. Okay, due to that length will be increased, and change in length divided by actual length is known as tensile strain. Second one, compressive strain. It can be write as EC, epsilon C, this one epsilon T. Okay, here the applied force compressive, then reduction of the length per unit length is known as compressive strain. It is negative. In here change length is increase, so del L will be positive, but in case of compressive del L will be negative, so compressive strain will be negative. Next one, shear strain. It is denoted by phi in generally, or some book you will find as tau. Shear strain is measure of angular deformation. Shear strain is defined as the change in angle between two originally orthogonal direction in continuum material. Initially, if we not applied any force, this is rectangular, okay, and this line and this line are perpendicular to each other. After applying shear force, shear stress, it is deformed in this shape, and this change in angle is known as shear strain. Okay, this change in angle is known as shear strain. Next one is volumetric strain. In volumetric strain means when you apply the force in all direction, so volume will be changed. Change in volume divided by actual volume is known as volumetric strain, and it will be equal to the strain in all three direction. Here volumetric strain epsilon V equal to epsilon X plus epsilon Y plus epsilon Z, that is strain in X axis, Y axis and Z axis. Okay, then come to the Poisson's ratio. Here when a body is subjected to an axial tensile load, okay, tensile load acting, there is an increase in length of body, length will be increased, but at the same time there is a decrease in other dimension of the body at right angle to the line of action of applied load. Means when we apply the tensile force, length will be increased, okay, but same time diameter or width, you can say, or cross section area will be decreased. Here, according to this, that one. And what is Poisson's ratio? Here when material is within elastic limit, the ratio of lateral strain to the longitudinal strain is called as Poisson's ratio, and it is generally denoted by mu this way or this way. Hence mathematically you can write mu equal to epsilon lateral divided by epsilon longitudinal. You can say strain, lateral strain divided by longitudinal strain. What is lateral strain? We are applying tensile force, so our applied load direction is this one, okay. So in this axis length will be increased, and that will be linear or longitudinal strain. Opposite to this, in other direction, in long perpendicular to the applied load, diameter is decreasing, so strain in diametral axis will be lateral strain, and that will be equal to change in diameter divided by actual diameter. Here you can see linear strain equal to change in length divided by actual length along the applied load, lateral strain equal to change in dimension in dimension in transverse axis divided by actual dimension. And how we can find out that one? From this formula itself, you can say we can find out lateral strain equal to mu longitude into longitudinal strain. Here we are using one negative. Why this negative came here? This negative we are using because if length is increasing, same time diameter will be decreased. Linear strain will be positive, then lateral strain will be negative. Due to that, we are using negative sign. Okay, so here primary linear or longitudinal strain, that is along the applied load, secondary or lateral strain, that is perpendicular to the applied load. Okay, so this is some values of the Poisson's ratio for mostly these are for the metal. Okay, the theoretical limit of Poisson's ratio lies between -1 to 0.5. keep note down, sometime this may be come in exam. These are two formula, we will discuss these two formula in next class. Okay, so according to these two formula, if all these three E, K and G will be positive, then this will be positive, these two value will be positive. From that we can find out the limit of Poisson's ratio. Okay, here itself you can see 1 minus 2 mu, that will be greater than 0, then only positive. So 1 will be greater than 2 mu, so 1 by 2 is greater than mu, so mu is less than 1 by 2, one condition complete. Second, 1 plus mu should be greater than 0, mu should be greater than -1, simply. So value of mu is varying from -1 to 0.5 for most, that is theoretical, but for most of the metal this is vary from 0.2 to 0.4 in between only. In some cases for composite material, some foam material, value may be negative. Thank you. In next class we'll discuss Hooke's law, shear strain curve, true stress, true strain, Young's modulus, modulus of ET, bulk modulus, continuous relationship between stress and strain for 1D, 2D, 3D, volumetric strain and factor of safety. All these topic will study in next class. Okay, thank you.